Hello, my dear students. Yesterday we have started discussion of introduction to organic chemistry. Okay, the study of organic compounds is called organic chemistry, right? And the study of hydrocarbons and their derivatives, is also called organic chemistry. Now see here. So the important property of carbon compounds, what we have discussed, the catenation. Catenation is the most important property of carbon. Okay, so what is catenation here? What I said, catenation means what? The self-linkage. The self-linkage of atoms of same element. Self-linkage of atoms of same element to form what? Long chains. The chains may be straight chains or ring chains. Okay, so that is what no catenation property. Which element has the highest catenation power? Carbon. So here, the carbon-carbon bond energy is what? 83 kilocalories per mole. What is the bond energy of carbon-carbon bond? 83 kilocalories per mole. And what is silicon-silicon bond energy? 54. Sulfur-sulfur, 54. Phosphorus-phosphorus bond energy? 50. Nitrogen-nitrogen bond energy? 39. Oxygen-oxygen, 35. Okay. So here catenation property, that is long chains of identical atoms. The similar atoms will form long chains. By which property? Catenation property. Okay, so catenation property depends upon the value of bond energy, which is maximum in case of carbon. So when carbon-carbon bond energy is greater, the catenation power also is greater. So catenation power depends on what, ma? Bond energy. More the bond energy, greater is the catenation power. That's why the carbon has highest catenation power. So which element has highest catenation power here? Carbon. That point keep in mind. Next to carbon, silicon. Next to carbon, silicon. The stability or strength, the stability of the bond, otherwise the strength of the bond decreases as the bond energy decreases. Okay, the stability decreases as the bond energy decreases. So the stability is the stability of the bond. Stability of the bond is directly proportional to what? Bond energy. Lesser the bond energy, less stability. Greater the bond energy, greater is the stability, like that. Hence, the tendency of catenation decreases in the following manner. So carbon has highest catenation power than silicon. And silicon, sulfur both have same bond energy, na? 54 kilocalories per mole. That's why they have same catenation power. And sulfur has greater catenation power than phosphorus. Phosphorus greater than nitrogen. Nitrogen greater than oxygen. So the similar atoms, atoms of same element linked to one another by catenation property. So which element has the highest catenation power? Carbon. Because of highest catenation power for the carbon atom, the carbon is able to form very large number of compounds. And next, carbon has the ability to form strong covalent bonds with many other atoms such as hydrogen, oxygen, sulfur, nitrogen, chlorine, bromine, iodine, etc. The carbon-carbon means carbon can form covalent bond with carbon and also with any one of these elements. The carbon-carbon bond energy is approximately equal to the magnitude of bond energies between carbon and various other atoms. Various other atoms. Okay, suppose you see bond energy of carbon-carbon, how much here? 83 kilocalories per mole. And carbon hydrogen is 97. Carbon oxygen is 86. So carbon hydrogen bond is having more bond energy. Carbon oxygen is having more bond energy. Carbon hydrogen. We should not take carbon double bond O. Carbon double bond O we should not take. Simply we take C single bond O. Bond energy is 86. C single bond H bond energy 97. And carbon carbon bond energy 83. Okay, so which one has more here? Carbon hydrogen has more even than what? Carbon carbon. This point keep in mind. And carbon chlorine bond energy is 81. Carbon nitrogen 73. Carbon bromine 68. So these bond energy values need not to by heart. Relatively, which bond is stronger than which bond, we have to understand. A carbon hydrogen bond energy is greater, na? Greater the bond energy, more is the stability. Greater is the strength of the bond. That point keep in mind. And different sources of organic compounds. There are two major sources of organic compounds. There are two major sources of organic compounds. They are natural sources and synthetic. Synthetic meaning what? Artificial. So artificial means synthetic here. So the natural sources of organic compounds and synthetic sources of organic compounds. The first one is what? Natural sources, plants, animals. Okay, so most of the organic compounds come from plants and animals. These all things I will send you. You can write down the notes. Okay. Next, fungi and microorganism. So microorganism and fungi. These also will be the sources for different types of antibiotics, acids, and different alcohols will get from fungi and microorganisms. Fungus, singular. Okay. Next, coal. From coal also we can get different types of organic compounds like dyes, drugs, perfumes, etc. Okay. And natural gas and petroleum. So generally natural gas will be available above the level of petroleum liquid, above the surface of the petroleum liquid. Which gas will be there? Natural gas will be accumulated. So natural gas is available above the surface of petroleum. Okay. So here petra means rock, oleum means oil. So when rocks are melted at high temperature and high pressure under the ground, what happens now? The rocks will be melted to form an oily substance called petroleum. Petra means rock. Oleum is oil. So natural gas and petroleum also will be the natural sources for organic compounds. So I will send you the PPT. You have to write notes later. And gasoline meaning what? Petrol. Remember. What is another name of gasoline? Petrol. So petrol. Okay. And kerosene. All these will be coming from petroleum. They are petroleum products, we say. The products of petroleum. Gasoline is nothing but petrol. Next. So the different organic compounds will be coming from these all natural sources, keep in mind. Then synthetic sources. Synthetic means for artificial. Only 10% of organic compounds will come from natural sources, remember. We have only 10% of organic compounds coming from natural sources, but remaining 90% will be from synthetic sources. Synthetic means for artificial. So more than 90% of the known organic compounds are synthetic, artificial. That is, prepared by artificial methods. Simple organic compounds derived from petroleum and coal have been converted into useful products by synthetic methods. By artificial methods, we can convert the compounds obtained from coal and petroleum into useful some products. Some useful products which are followed by what? Some synthetic methods. In synthetic methods, we can convert the products of coal and petroleum into some useful products in our day-to-day life. Nowadays, many of the natural products such as dyes, fibers, rubber, drugs, vitamins, etc. are prepared from different sources by synthetic reactions only, means artificial reactions only. By synthetic methods means artificial methods only we can prepare most of these substances, organic substances. Okay, so drugs will be two types, natural drugs and synthetic drugs. Rubber will be two types, natural rubber, synthetic rubber. Fibers will be two types, natural fibers, artificial fibers. In this way, we have both natural and artificial things. Next, sources of organic compounds. So natural sources, source is only 10%. Synthetic source, 90%, remember. Most of the organic compounds coming from synthetic methods only. By synthetic methods only, we can prepare. And natural sources, what? Plants, animals, fungi and organisms, microorganisms, coal, natural gas and petroleum. These all come under natural sources. Okay, synthetic means from different chemicals we prepare organic compounds. Next, bonding in organic compounds. Different types of organic compounds have different bonds. So most of the organic compounds have covalent bonding here. Which type of bond will be there? Covalent bond will be there. We have three types of bonds. Ionic bonding, covalent bonding and dative. So dative bond is nothing but coordinate covalent bond. So which type of bonding mostly will be available here? Covalent bond will be there. Most of the organic compounds contain covalent bond here. They are covalent compounds, we say. Okay. Next. So bonding in organic compounds. Organic compounds are essentially covalent compounds. They are mostly, mainly covalent compounds. Or covalent bonding is present in organic compounds. Okay. In all organic molecules, carbon atom is tetravalent. Tetravalent means how many bonds it will form? 4 bonds. Each carbon atom can form how many bonds? 4 bonds. That is, its valence is 4. Valency of carbon is 4. So, tetravalent atom. One carbon atom can share its 4 electrons with 4 atoms of an univalent atom like hydrogen and halogen. Hydrogen, otherwise halogen. X indicates what? Halogen. Halogen may be fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. So these halogens and hydrogen will come under univalent elements. Univalent element meaning what? Each hydrogen can form single bond. Each halogen can form single bond. So each carbon can share 4 valence electrons of it with how many univalent elements? 4 univalent elements. Okay, forming 4 single covalent bonds. See here, carbon has 4 valence electrons. And 4 hydrogens we have taken. Each hydrogen has 1 valence electron. The cross is electron of hydrogen. The dot is taken as electron of carbon. When these two atoms approach each other, these two types of elements, atoms approach each other, what happens now? Carbon is sharing its 4 electrons with 4 hydrogen atoms. Okay, 4 hydrogen atoms are what? Monovalent atoms or univalent atoms. So carbon has got how many bonds? 1, 2, 3, 4. So carbon has 4 bonds. Okay. So whenever carbon has 4 bonds like this, 4 single bonds. So 4 single covalent bonds. If carbon has 4 single covalent bonds, that carbon is called sp3 carbon. Already we have discussed the types of hybridization in chemical bonding. Types of hybridization. sp hybridization, sp2 hybridization, sp3 hybridization. So carbon can undergo 3 types of hybridization. sp, sp2, sp3. Which is sp3 carbon generally? If carbon has 4 single covalent bonds around it, that carbon is called sp3 carbon. In sp3 carbon, 25% what is there? Which character? S character. 25% what is there? S character is there. And what is the percentage of p character here? 75%. 75% p character and 25% s character. Why 25% here? How many s orbitals mixed here in sp3 formation? In sp3 hybridization process, one s orbital of carbon will mix with how many p orbitals of carbon? 3 p orbitals. One s orbital intermixes with 3 p orbitals of carbon. Then how many intermixing with each other? Totally one s orbital and 3 p orbitals. Totally 4 orbitals are forming here. 4 hybrid orbitals will be forming in sp3 hybridization. So how many s orbitals here? 1 s orbital divided by total number of orbitals, how many? 4. 4 orbitals. Totally how many orbitals available here? 4 orbitals. One s orbital is there out of 4 orbitals into 100 is equal to how much percentage? 25%. So 1 by 4 into 100, 25% is s character. And how to calculate p character here? P percentage. The percentage of p character is equal to what? How many p orbitals involved here in the sp3 hybridization? 3 p orbitals. So 3 p orbitals divided by total number of orbitals, how many involved here? Totally 4. So 4 orbitals. Out of 4 orbitals, how many p orbitals are there here? 3 p orbitals are there here. 3 p orbitals. That's why 3 by 4 into 100 is equal to what? 75%. So 75% p character, 25% s character in sp3 carbon. So this carbon is now sp3. What is the name of this molecule? Methane. Already we know this. Methane. Meth indicates how many carbon atoms? 1 carbon atom. Yeah, only if one carbon is present in the organic molecule, we use the word meth. Okay? AN means what? All single bonds around the carbon. AN indicates what here? All single bonds around the carbon. So methane indicates the molecule with one carbon atom having all 4 single bonds around it. Single covalent bonds. So it is methane molecule. Okay? So it is about what now here? Formation of 4 bonds by carbon atom. Take screenshot if you want. Next. Okay. Next here. One carbon atom can share its 4 electrons, 4 valence electrons with 2 atoms of bivalent element. Here oxygen is bivalent element. Each oxygen can form two bonds like this. Otherwise, two bonds like this. Okay, double bond with oxygen. Otherwise, oxygen with two single bonds. Oxygen may form two single bonds on either side. Otherwise, oxygen can form one double bond like this. Okay, so with bivalent atoms. Bi means what? Two. Valency two here. With bivalent atoms, carbon can share how many valence electrons of it? Four valence electrons of it, right? Forming how many double bonds? Here two double bonds, two double covalent bonds. Okay, suppose you take here in this case, here carbon has one double bond with oxygen atom and double bond with another oxygen atom. So carbon has totally how many double bonds around it? Two double bonds. Totally how many bonds around the carbon? Four bonds. Okay, one, two, three, four. Totally four covalent bonds around the carbon. So carbon has got four bonds around it. So the tetravalency of carbon is satisfied here. And oxygen has how many bonds? Double bond, means two covalent bonds. So each oxygen is satisfied with two valency, valency two. Like this here, carbon has four valence electrons on it. And two oxygen atoms we have taken. Each oxygen has six valence electrons. Oxygen belongs to group 16, right? Group 16 means what here? Six valence electrons will be there. So how many oxygen atoms we have taken? Two oxygen atoms. Now when they approach each other, what happens now here? The central carbon shares its four electrons. Central carbon atom shares its four electrons with the electrons of oxygen to form what? C double bond O and double bond O. The central atom is carbon. Why here? The central atom is what always? Less electronegative atom. Between carbon and oxygen, which is having more electronegativity? Oxygen has greater electronegativity. Carbon has lesser electronegativity. So in the polyatomic molecules, which one is central atom? The central atom is one with lesser electronegativity. And which atoms cannot form central atoms? Hydrogen and fluorine. So hydrogen and fluorine, these two elements can never form central atoms. They can never form central atom. They can never constitute the central atom of a molecule. Okay, hydrogen and fluorine. For remaining cases, what we have to check? The carbon is less electronegative in this molecule, CO2 molecule. Therefore, carbon is central atom here. Or one carbon atom can share its four valence electrons with one atom of a bivalent element along with two atoms of univalent element. That is forming one double bond and two single bonds. The carbon can form what? One double bond and two single bonds. One double bond can be forming with bivalent oxygen. Here this single bond with univalent hydrogen. This single bond with univalent hydrogen. So the same molecule, what we say here? H bond CHO, we can say. H bond CHO like this. So H bond CHO is called formaldehyde. What is the name of this? Formaldehyde. So what is the formula of formaldehyde? HCHO. So here the carbon has formed one double bond with oxygen, two single bonds with hydrogen atoms. A double bond is covalent bond, single bonds also covalent bonds. It is double covalent bond, these two are single covalent bonds. Like this. So here carbon has four valence electrons around it and two hydrogen atoms with one valence electron and one oxygen atom with six valence electrons. All right, Lewis structures we have discussed in chemical bonding. Lewis structures. How to draw Lewis structure? Once go through this, take the screenshots and go through this once again. Recall the chemical bonding topic. Okay, so here the carbon has formed one bond with hydrogen here, one bond with hydrogen here. In one bond, how many electrons will be there? Two electrons. In this one bond, how many electrons there? Two electrons. Here between oxygen carbon, how many electrons shared? Four electrons. The four electrons shared will form how many bonds? Two bonds. So C double bond O should be there here. C double bond O. And between C and H, single bond. Between C and H, again single bond. Or one carbon atom can share its four valence electrons with one atom of a trivalent element. Tri valent element. Trivalent element along with one atom of univalent element. That is forming one triple bond and one single bond. Okay, now you take this molecule here, HCN. HCN indicates what here? Hydrogen cyanide. In this here, the central atom again what? Carbon. Why central atom is carbon here? Less electronegative element should be forming central atom. Actually here carbon has 2.5, hydrogen has 2.1. Here less electronegative, hydrogen only actually. But hydrogen can never form central atom na? That's why hydrogen must be surrounding atom only. Hydrogen must be terminal atom only. It cannot be central atom. So central atom is carbon here because carbon has less electronegativity than nitrogen. That is why carbon central atom. So carbon has formed 3 bonds with nitrogen, which is trivalent element, and 1 bond with hydrogen, which is univalent atom. So single bond with univalent atom, the triple bond with trivalent atom. Okay. Carbon atom has also the wonderful property of uniting with other carbon atoms. Carbon atoms can combine with again carbon atoms through covalent bonds. Carbon can again combine with another carbon. They can link together by single bonds, double bonds, and triple covalent bonds. Carbon-carbon can be linked with single covalent bond or double covalent bond or triple covalent bonds, forming long chains or closed structures. The closed chains or open chains may be forming here. Now check here this molecule. In this molecule here, the carbon-carbon single bond is there here. Carbon-carbon single bond is available. So this carbon-carbon single bond is available, and also carbon-hydrogen single bonds there. So this carbon, if you check, around this carbon, how many bonds available? 4 bonds. All 4 are single bonds. Around this carbon also, 4 single bonds. Around this carbon also, 4 single bonds. Around each hydrogen, 1 bond. So each hydrogen is monovalent or univalent. Each carbon is tetravalent. Here carbon-carbon single bond is there. If carbon-carbon single bond is there, that is called saturated compound, remember. Saturated compound, organic compound. So the organic compound is called saturated organic compound if there are only carbon-carbon single bonds. If there is no double bond and triple bond, that compounds with only single bonds are called saturated organic compounds, remember. Now see here, around this carbon, how many single bonds? 4 single bonds. So this carbon must be called sp3 carbon. Why sp3 carbon again? Carbon with only single bonds. Here also, carbon with all 4 single bonds. Again sp3 carbon atom. sp3 carbon, sp3 carbon. So the single bond is between which carbon atoms now? sp3 carbon, single bond, sp3 carbon. Is that clear, ma? Next. Next type of structure, you check it here. In this case, now carbon-carbon double bond is there, check it. Carbon-carbon double bond. So carbon-carbon single bond is possible. Carbon-carbon double bond is also possible. Now when carbon-carbon double bond is available, remaining 2 bonds will be with hydrogen. And this carbon has already double bond, remaining 2 bonds with hydrogen atoms. Like this here, CH2 double bond CH2. How to write the same thing? CH2 double bond CH2. So CH2 double bond CH2, we can write like this. Here carbon-carbon double bond is there. It is called double covalent bond. Carbon-carbon double covalent bond, we say. Here, now in this molecule, check it. In this molecule, CH, triple bond CH, where carbon-carbon triple bond is there, and one bond with hydrogen. So carbon-carbon triple bond, carbon-carbon double bond, and also carbon-carbon single bond possible. Here, this is open chain or closed chain? It is open chain. It is also open chain. But you check here, benzene. In this benzene molecule, is it open chain or closed chain? It is closed chain. See how many carbons? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 carbons formed a ring chain. Ring chain. Closed chain. Closed structure it is. Now see here, carbon-carbon double bond. Again, carbon-carbon single bond. Carbon-carbon double bond. carbon carbon single, carbon carbon double, carbon carbon single. So alternate double bonds available here. Alternate double bonds, right, ma? So like this here, the carbon has what now here? One single bond with carbon, one double bond with carbon. Already how many bonds around this carbon now? One, two, three already there. So one with four, fourth bond with hydrogen, single bond with hydrogen. Like this, every carbon in benzene molecule attaches to one hydrogen atom. So it is what now here? Benzene. What is the name of this molecule? Benzene molecule. C6H6 benzene. So it is closed organic compound, and the alternate double bond is available here. Okay, about these all molecules we are going to discuss. So here, which type of carbon-carbon bonding available here? Carbon-carbon single bond, carbon-carbon double bond. Now check here. Each carbon, around each carbon here, double bond is there, na? At least one double bond is there here. If at least one double bond is there, that carbon must be called sp2 carbon. What is the carbon here? sp2 carbon. When we say it is sp2 carbon, if carbon has at least one double bond, if carbon has at least one double bond and two single bonds around it, that carbon must be taken as sp2 carbon. sp2 carbon. In this sp2 hybridization process, how many s orbitals will involve? One s orbital and two p orbitals involved here. So what is the percentage of s character? S percentage how much here? S percentage. One s orbital out of totally how many? Three. Here one s orbital mixed with two p orbitals, na? Totally how many mixed? Three into 100. So 1/3 × 100 is s percentage. So 33.3%. And what is the percentage of p? P percentage. How many p orbitals involved here? Two. Two p orbitals out of totally how many orbitals involved? One s orbital, two p orbitals, totally three. 2/3 × 100. How much it is? 66.6. Is that clear, ma'am? So like this here. So p percentage and s percentage we have to understand in sp2 carbon. When we say it is sp2 carbon, if carbon has at least one double bond. Now we check here. In this case, here around this carbon, if you observe, one triple bond is there, one single bond is there. One triple bond and one single bond. So it is what now? sp carbon. Which carbon it is called? sp carbon. In sp carbon, what is the s percentage? Here one s orbital out of how many? Two. One s orbital involved and one p orbital is involved. That is, one s orbital is mixed with one p orbital. Totally how many orbitals? Two. One s orbital out of 2 × 100. 1/2 × 100, how much here? 50%. So 50% s character, 50% p character in sp carbon. Okay, so now this type of hybridization is called sp hybridization, and the orbitals formed by hybridization are called hybrid orbitals. How many hybrid orbitals in this sp? Two hybrid orbitals. How many sp hybrid orbitals will be there? Two sp hybrid orbitals will be available in each carbon. Here this carbon is triple bonded carbon, is sp carbon. This carbon also what? Sp carbon. Why this carbon is also sp carbon? Because again this carbon is having one triple bond, one single bond, so sp carbon. Here this is sp2 carbon, this one sp2 carbon, sp2. Every carbon in benzene molecule has at least one double bond. Every carbon is having at least one double bond. That's why the double bonded carbon must be taken as what? sp2 carbon. And triple bonded carbon is called sp carbon, and single bonded carbon is called sp3 carbon. Single bonded carbon is called sp3 carbon. Okay, that point we have to keep in mind. Next one, one more thing what you have to understand is that suppose one molecule you take like this here. Carbon double bond, carbon double bond like this. So one molecule is this one. What is the formula? C3O2. This is carbon suboxide. What is the name of this? Carbon suboxide. In this carbon suboxide, you check it here. Around this carbon, How many double bonds are there? Two double bonds. This is one double bond one side. This is also double bond other side. Okay. So if carbon has two sides double bond, this carbon must be called sp carbon. What is the carbon here? Sp or sp2 or sp3? Sp hybrid carbon. Sp hybrid carbon we say. This one also has double bond, two sides double bond. Sp carbon. Again, sp carbon. This one also has both double bonds, so sp carbon. So how many sp carbons in this molecule of carbon suboxide? There are three sp carbons. And in the surrounding atoms, hybridization won't be there. In the surrounding atoms, hybridization will not be there. Only in central atom, the hybridization process occurs. Here in each carbon, how many s orbitals mixed with how many p orbitals? One s orbital of this carbon mixed with one p orbital. To form how many hybrid orbitals? Two hybrid orbitals. So here, two sp hybrid orbitals are there. Here, two sp hybrid orbitals are there. Here, two sp hybrid orbitals are there. And already we have discussed in chemical bond topic that whenever sp hybridization occurs, that molecule will get linear shape. What is shape of the molecule in which sp hybridization occurs? Linear shape. Linear shape. Okay. Now see here. The four valencies of carbon atom are similar and they are symmetrically arranged around the carbon atom. Okay. All the four valencies will be similar. According to Liebel and Van 't Hoff, two scientists here. Liebel and Van 't Hoff. According to these two scientists, the four valencies of carbon do not lie in one plane, do not present in one plane. They are directed towards the corners of a regular tetrahedron. Tetrahedron means what now? Like this. Okay, it is tetrahedron, regular tetrahedron. Okay, the four bonds will be directed towards four corners of the tetrahedral structure with carbon atom at the center. At the center of this tetrahedral structure, what will be there? Carbon will be there. At the center of this tetrahedron, carbon will be present. And the angle between any two valencies is 109 degrees, 28 minutes or 109.5 degrees. 109 degrees, 28 minutes or 109.5 degrees we take here. So what is the bond angle here between this bond, bond angle is how much? 109 degrees, 28 minutes. Otherwise 109.5 degrees. And this carbon has four single bonds, na? That's why it is sp3 carbon. What is this carbon called? sp3 carbon. So sp3 hybridization, if it occurs, the bond angle will be generally 109 degrees, 28 minutes. So this is called what now here? sp3 bond angle. What is this called? sp3 bond angle. sp3 bond angle how much? 109 degrees, 28 minutes. So who gave this idea? Tetrahedron structure, Liebel and Van 't Hoff. These two scientists. Modern concept of covalent bonding. According to the modern concept, a covalent bond is formed between two atoms if there is an overlapping of an atomic orbital of one atom with an atomic orbital of other atom. When two atoms approach each other, atomic orbital of one atom will mix with atomic orbital of other atom. Suppose you take here, you take p orbital, dumbbell shape na p orbital of one atom plus again, p orbital of another atom. So it is one atom, it is one atom. P orbital, p atomic orbital of one carbon atom, p atomic orbital of another carbon atom. When they approach each other, when the two carbons approach each other, what happens? This carbon, the two atomic orbitals will overlap. They will overlap like this here. They will overlap with each other. So this is called orbital overlapping. So this is extent of overlapping. What is called? Extent of overlapping. So this orbital overlapping will lead to the formation of covalent bonding. This type of orbital overlapping will lead to the formation of what? Covalent bond. Okay. So this type of overlapping between two orbitals which lie on the same axis. Here it is axis. It is also axis. Internuclear axis. when both the orbitals are on the same axis, this type of overlapping is called axial overlapping. Both orbitals which are getting overlapped are present on the same axis, so this is called axial overlapping or linear overlapping. We say axial overlapping, otherwise linear overlapping. It will form sigma bond. Remember, which bond is formed here? Sigma bond is formed here. This symbol indicates for sigma. So sigma PP bond. Sigma PP bond is formed here. Sigma PP means what? Between p orbital of one atom and p orbital of another atom, the axial overlapping taken place to form sigma PP bond. So this is sigma bond formed between this carbon and this carbon. So carbon single bond is formed here. Now this single bond is what now here? The single bond is PP bond, PP sigma bond, PP sigma bond. So this way we have to understand what the modern concept of formation of covalent bond by orbital overlapping. Sometimes two p orbitals will be parallel to each other like this. Both are parallel to each other. They will overlap sideways here. This will lead to the formation of pi bond, PP pi bond. So PP pi bond is formed by sidewise overlapping or lateral overlapping. Lateral overlapping or sidewise overlapping will form pi bond. Sideways overlapping will lead to the formation of pi bond. Axial overlapping will form sigma bond. So sigma PP, pi PP bond.